Hey everybody, I'm here at London Driveline. I'm getting shafted. Anyways, this is the Mazda flange on this side. And this is the Mazda hanger bearing and the Mazda shaft. We don't need this. We're going to make Mazda N, Toyota N. I'm just going to lengthen the shaft about 62 or 63 inches. So this will get lengthened. And this is the shaft from the 2004 Dodge. What happened was it was left in four-wheel drive and hit dry pavement and it's a weak spot in the drive system. Luckily it didn't take out this, Scott said. Of course only the best universal joints, right? Are good things about those guys.
Yeah, those are the good ones.
This is my old flange?
Yeah.
She pooched?
Yeah.
I have to clip this off to get it off. On the front differential, it has Torx, and those torque head bolts are they're rounding as I'm trying to take them out, eh? Looks like a good dealership job to take that off. Unless you guys have the technology.
Not for them, no.
Holy crap, man, this would have taken me like 2 hours. There we go. There we are, all fixed up. Put it all back together. Get me going again. Yup, you need immediate service, take it here. You did great work. Scott will fix you right up, he's super fast. That flange, I was lucky I didn't take that out, but that was pretty expensive. But those bearings, or universal joints, last a long time, and all those bearings go out as soon as the universal joint breaks. So I was very fortunate that it wasn't any more than what it was. But definitely recommend these guys, and I gotta get them the correct measurement, and then they can finish off that Mazda shaft for me. Just time to change the oil on the 2010 Hino. I'm just dropping the oil there, changing the filter. Let's have a peek. Never done this before on a Hino, so I don't really know how much it was coming out. But yeah, it looks about, that looks like about 20 liters there. Yeah, it's coming down, slowing down to a dribble. There's the oil filter. I just wanted to let that seep a little bit. Oil filter. Black blood. Let's open it up a crack. Yeah, it's got the breakdown at 5,000 kilometers. I'm supposed to do a checklist of everything. So all that good funness. And then get this, the Hino genuine oil, you get 15,000 kilometers between oil changes. They said regular oil change, or regular oil, is every 10,000. So I price compared in the genuine Hino oil, and I said to the sales guy, I said, or the service guy, I said, well, I bet you it's double the price. And yeah, it is double the price, so it just doesn't make sense to do it, and plus you can it doesn't void my warranty at all using regular oil, so I don't have anything to worry about that way. This is the most up-to-date oil. And yeah, I asked for Shell, and then came with the Quaker State logo on it. So I said, I don't know what the deal is with that. The company that sold this to me said that was as surprised as I was, but he said he looked into it, and he said Quaker State is owned by Shell. I don't know if that's true or not, or if you just put that chain around the oil filter. Man, that works for a variety of applications, all different sizes and whatnot. It's perfect for doing oil changes. Look at this wannabe Cummins. Got that 73 in it. He does derby cars all over the place. He's always in the winner's circle. So I just bought a whole whack of converters off of him. Wheel, but without his helmet on.
Oh, my lord.
Kevin, how are you doing?
Not bad.
So when your power stroke grows up, is it going to be a Cummins?
No.
Well, we're still trying to convert him over to Dodge, but I don't know if it'll ever work in this lifetime.